Hey there, folks. Today I'd like to take a casual peek into my Goody Haul report for the third week of August of 2012. Today is Tuesday, August 21st. And these past couple weeks have been very interesting. A real roller coaster ride of highs and lows where it comes to real life, for me personally. If you haven't heard in the community already, one of my good friends, Mike McBride, also known as Nine Fires on YouTube and Facebook, he unfortunately passed away on August 3rd, 2012. He just turned 37 about a week before. And I just learned about it last week, and I was greatly shocked, for one. I really don't ever expect any of my good friends to pass away, but I was shocked, really saddened, and really just bummed out. I really couldn't do anything too much goody-wise, and it just really took me out of it, and I really couldn't even post any videos other than a video I did over the weekend, just a brief, I guess, memorial to my good friend. And I met Mike online back in 2010, in October. I received an email from him asking me, I guess he had seen some of my Lord of the Rings videos. He had asked me, he was interested in those Lord of the Rings figures, possibly for the fantasy element, to either use or collect. And he had asked me if any of these figures had any gimmicks. He wanted to avoid any figures with gimmicks. And I was glad to help anybody out. And at the time, I shot, I think it was a 6-part video. Back then in 2010, you were limited to 15 minutes per video before you were a partner. And so I shot a video on, and I remember this, this was on Halloween day, or close to getting to Halloween night. And I shot this hour and a half long video of showing off my Lord of the Rings collection, just to help him out, to show him all the figures that I had and which ones had gimmicks and stuff. And that was my first encounter with Mike, and online, and enjoyed his friendship since then. We've I like to say we've gotten close over the interwebs. I've exchanged gifts back and forth, talked between each other back and forth about our various hobbies and life in general. And I really am going to miss him. Just really shocked that he's no longer with us. But he is, I want to believe that he is with us in spirit. So, like I said earlier, I really couldn't do anything other than shoot a memorial vid. And basically, some of the figures that we shared a common interest in, you saw earlier, some figures like the Pit, the Turtles, Iron Man, Black Widow, all of the figures that were on display had some sort of connection between me and Mike. And a personal connection, you know, like the Sasquatch figure, for example. He was a figure that I was going to give to him. Well, he was actually looking just for the Cable for Apocalypse, the Apocalypse Build-A-Figure. And he happened to be looking for a Sasquatch figure as well. So I decided to surprise him because I saw one on sale. And I was going to ship it to him, but then found out that he already gotten a Sasquatch figure. So this was right as I was about to mail it off, but decided, since he already got a Sasquatch figure, I didn't have one. I decided to keep the Sasquatch figure and just send the Cable instead. But for some reason, there was a miscommunication on what was going there and what was being kept, and he thought I was upset at him for him buying that Sasquatch figure. But just a really big misunderstanding, nothing major. We never got into a big argument or anything, just a friendly argument. But I was able to ship him that Cable to him, along with some other stuff like the Black Widow and the Iron Man figure, and I think I sent him a Deadpool and Warpath figure, I can't remember, and also a Smeagol and Gollum figure. It was a sort of a surprise. It was more of like an after Christmas present, although he didn't believe in Christmas. But anyways, just those figures in that memorial had some personal connection between the two of us. Some other examples, of course, Pit. I purchased the Pit figure based on his viewpoints on it, being one of his more favorite figures, and that motivated me to getting a Pit. There were other figures, some that he didn't have, like the Spider-Man figure, what they call the McFarlane Spider-Man figure. I know that he was a big fan of Spider-Man, but he was looking for a McFarlane Spider-Man, and I wasn't going to tell him, but I was on the lookout for one for him as well. And unfortunately, I was never able to find one, because those are pretty hard to find, on, especially on eBay. But I wish I had found one before he passed. And just all these other figures that we had a connection to. And also, I did build this out of some Mega Bloks here. This is a sort of a memorial to Nine Fires here. Just something I wanted to create and keep on display just to remember him by. But a really great guy on the interwebs, and I'm gonna miss him very much. But that was really, of course, the low period. The low period this past couple weeks, which was, I guess, sort of balanced out with some really good periods as well. I finally I was able to get that one goodie that I've been talking about for the past several months, our brand new home. I don't know if you saw the video of that, but I posted that back in August 10th. That was when we were going to sign the paperwork at title. And yeah, that was how many days ago? Almost 2 weeks ago. And but we finally got the keys to the house. Finally recorded it. Documents were finally recorded just yesterday on Monday, so we were finally able to get the keys. Just a little bit of snafus between the signing of a title, just all these last minute little things requiring signatures and questions and all that kind of stuff. But finally got the house, and I'll post a link to the video of that went on August 10th. And so that's a real highlight for me and my family. And it's not a huge house by any means, just enough size for our family. And in a great neighborhood that wife one and only really loves. She loves the community that we purchased the house at. And over the past year, we were looking for houses and just really placing offers on them, getting outbid, or just too many offers where they even wouldn't even look at our offer. And just spent the whole year looking for houses. And during that time, we've looked at houses in different areas, but wife one and only always had a preference for the neighborhood that where we purchased our house here. And I don't think she really took any serious offers at any of the houses that were outside of the area, although I had an interest in them. But we're happy. We have a very nice neighborhood, a nice gated community, a very quiet neighborhood, and just a really great place. Finally, a big enough place to put my goodies because the current place. Before we purchased the house, we were living in a very small apartment, and I just really didn't have any room for any of my goodies, and really only just two shelves out of the entire place, and a lot of it in storage and stuff. So with this new home, hopefully I'll have a little bit more room to display my goodies, although I don't know if I'll have that much more if my family has any say. So I don't know, maybe I might have a bit of a man cave, a small man cave that I can lay claim to for my goodies. Very highs and lows this past couple weeks, goodie-wise. And we'll go ahead and get started with what I was able to get in these past couple weeks. Not too much, but we'll go ahead and get started. What we have here are some more blind bags of Mario Kart Wii. Looks like Walmart is now starting to sell them. I first saw them at Toys R Us, but I believe these are sort of a Series 2 because, let me turn this down a little bit here. And, oops, it's a little bright. There we go. And these here are blind packs. I believe they're Series 2 because the first series had set figures in the packs, like these here. I was able to find at Target another Bowser. I was able to find an additional Bowser, but the first series had set figures, so you knew what they were coming in or what was in the bags, like this one here, a Bowser. But for Series 2, they're more blind bags, so you really don't know unless you're tactile skills are pretty high, or if you actually open them before you purchase them, but you really don't know what you're getting. But I purchased three of these. These are basically $3 a piece at Walmart. Pretty cool. And like I said, I did find this at Target for $3 as well. And this is definitely a Bowser. Over at Walmart, I did pick up this here. This is really from Munchkin number 2. But a Lego City, looks like a rover, Space Moon Buggy. And this one here is $3.50 on clearance at Walmart. And like I said, really from Munchkin number 2 because he likes building stuff as of recently. And he's gonna have fun with that. See here, I was able to purchase this at Toys R Us, some Mini Mates. And this one here is of Nightcrawler and Betsy Braddock before her transformation into Psylocke, you could say. This one here is an older Minimates. I'm not sure what series this is, but I decided to pick it up before it disappeared altogether. And pretty nice on Nightcrawler there and Betsy Braddock there. And also at Toys R Us, I was able to pick up this here, Minimates. This is the Capcom versus Marvel, or Marvel versus Capcom 3. And this is from Series 3, I think. Series 2. No, I think it's Series 2. Of MODOK and Akuma. And these are just coming out, at least in my area. And I was also able to pick up this one as well. The Thor and Amaterasu. I believe he's from the, or she's from, is it a she? Yeah, it's a she. It's a female. She's from the Okami video game, from what I remember, back in PlayStation 2, I think. And, of course, we have, a modern Thor there, an armored Thor there. And I really wanted it for this figure here, of the dog-like figure. Pretty unique there, as far as Minimates go. And I also picked up this one at Target, not Target, but Toys R Us as well. The Minimates from the previous version of Marvel vs. Capcom 3 of the Sentinel and first appearance Ryu on there. So I think he's coming out again in the second series or third series. I'm not sure which one. But those were all about $7.50. Was able to pick up this here. I'm trying to remember where I got this one. I think it was Walmart. This is from Series 3. Yeah, Series 3 of Hero Factory. I have the whole set of starter canisters for Series 3, but I want to build a combo mode, so I'm going to need to get another set of the canisters. And I was able to find this. These you really can't find anymore at retail. Happy to see this one at retail and pick this one up here. Let's see. Oh, yeah. I got this here at a Target. This is the Metalman Iron figure. And this is on their continuing that clearance of DC Universe Classics figures at Target. Got this one for about $4.89 or 98 cents or something like that, and I already have an Iron. I just decided to pick him up since he's cheap, and you know, Iron here. Anybody looking to complete their Metalman, especially with the Platinum and Tin coming out, to really boost the Metalman build, army build. Again, not army build, but team build. So. I got it for anybody that may be looking to complete their Metalman, or enhance their Metalman team. But for $5, that's not too bad. Oops. And let's see here. Oh yeah. I was able to pick these up at Target as well. These are the Lex season sets of Season 1, 2, and 3. And I actually remember watching Lex several years back. It was like a late night, I think it was on Sci-Fi Channel. I wasn't familiar with this series at all. And from what I remember watching, it was a bit bizarre and really off-humored, you can say. It's got this quirkiness about this show. I think this is a Canadian show, I'm not sure. But I haven't watched it. I don't know, it's been almost 10 years, maybe? I can't remember when this was first released. But I didn't even think about this show until I actually saw these discs at Target. They were on sale for $3.99 per season set here. Well, it seems like Season 1 is just a bunch of movies. but it completes second and third seasons. So it, basically three seasons of Lex for $3.99 per set. Pretty cheap, and decided to pick them up because from what I remember years ago, seeing the few episodes that were on late, I think it was like Friday night or Saturday night on the Sci-Fi channel. And I think there are four seasons. I'm not sure why they didn't have the fourth season. Maybe it isn't produced yet. I'm not sure. I have to do some research and find out. But basically, $12 for three seasons is not too bad on there. So, got those. And let's see here. Looks like I may have to take a break here because I'm running out of time on my card. So, I'll be right back. Alright, we're back, and still have a few things I'd like to share with everyone that I was able to find. This Toys R Us. I was able to find this here. Looks like Lord of the Rings line of LEGO figures. They're starting to produce those single packaged with the minifigure items. They do that with Star Wars and other sublines, and looks like they're doing it with Lord of the Rings, and it looks like you have a I'm not sure if that's Frodo or Bilbo on there. I'm gonna guess Frodo on there, and he's got a bit of a stove there and a keg going on, which is kind of cool. So this will be my first Lord of the Rings minifigure, so that should be interesting. And I was able to pick up, I think, this one at Walmart and this one at Toys R Us. These are basically the mini scale, I guess you can call it, of Star Wars capital ships, the miniaturized versions. And I had recently purchased some model kits from Star Trek, and I saw these in a, I guess similar scale, not really, but. With my modeling bug, I saw these and I decided to pick them up because they're kind of cool for miniature scale capital ships here, of a Republic attack cruiser and Star Destroyer. I believe these were like $3 or $4 a piece. Kind of cool. Got those at Target. I was able to find this here. This is the Steve Rogers from the first series of the Return of Marvel Legends. And turn that down there. And this here was, I guess, a restock from Target. Because these were gone for a while. It looks like they just restocked them. And I got this for $15. I already have one of each type. There's a variant, one with a phase shield and this one here, the solid shield. I just decided to pick up another one in case someone may be looking for one, or maybe I might sell it off eBay, I'm not sure. Got that. Able to find this at Walmart. Kind of cool. This is the Avengers comic collection. Basically, the movie Avengers characters in their comic book form. There's two sets of these. They're Walmart exclusives, and let me just adjust the camera here. And they're two box sets, one of Thor, Iron Man, Black Widow, and I can't remember who else. And this box set of Hulk, Loki, Iron Man again, and Hawkeye. And they're basically re-releases of Marvel Universe figures. The comic versions of the characters. I got this one specifically for this guy here because this particular Hulk is a new figure, and this was on clearance down, I think, $9. This used to be $30, down to $21. And I have all of these figures already, but this one here, this Iron Man, which I believe came out with the one of the larger figures, the giant figures. I can't remember if it was Giant Man or the Skrull, I can't remember, this one came out with one of those two figures, but the paint on this one's a little bit different, and Got the this Loki came out with Frost Giant. I only had one other one, so this will be my second one. And he came, Hawkeye came out in the Secret Wars, and I think there was a Dark Hawkeye that used the same mold in a single pack. But this one here is pretty much unique. This is the Hulk in the purple pants, using the World War Hulk body mold, I think. A remolded head, of course, pants, but the design is from the World War Hulk figure. But nice to have this version of the Hulk compared to the first release of Marvel Universe Hulk, which I was never happy with. So I'm really happy to get that. And I understand that this guy is coming out single-carded form as well. I don't know if he's different from this box set or not. Maybe a slight paint difference, but it looks almost exactly the same based on the videos I've seen of the single-release Hulk. But I have not seen any of the new single-release of Marvel Universe at all, although other folks around the country have. I got this one just in case I may never find it. So for $21, for four figures, two of them that I kind of are newish to me. So, but pretty cool. This is the other box set here. Oh, Captain America is the other figure in that set that I forgot. So, and those are straight up re-releases of Marvel Universe. I don't plan to pick that one up at all. So, but pretty cool. Over at another Walmart, I was able to find Avengers figures. Found this one here. This is a Hawkeye, movie Hawkeye, and this will be my second or third one, I think. But I just picked him up because I really like that figure. It's a really nice figure there. And I was also able to find this one here. This one is Nick Fury, movie Nick Fury. And it looks like he's using the Winter Soldier body mold on there. But I could be wrong, but that's what it looks like to me. And with just some added bits and pieces there. But this is the first time I've seen this one. I think this is one of the later releases here. It has, of course, the Chitauri here and another version of Iron Man there. I think this is an improved version than the earlier released Mark 7. So, but pretty interesting, and he's numbered 17, so pretty interesting there. And got this at Walmart for, I think it was like $10. Seems that the going rate for these 4-inch figures nowadays. Oh, I did see this at Walmart too. This is really from Munchkin number 2. This is a Shogun Ranger in his Ranger mode. It looks like only Red Ranger is going to have this outfit here. And I'm not sure if this is harder to find, because I've seen all the other ones except for this Shogun Ranger figure. So I'm glad to have picked this one up, because we won't have to hunt for this one anymore. At Target, I was able to pick this one up, the third season of Fringe. And this was on sale last week. They had a whole bunch of TV on DVD for like $17. And I was waiting for a price drop on this to pick this up, and finally they dropped the price on Fringe on this one to $17 on sale. And I missed most of this third season. I saw pretty much all of season 1 and parts of season 2, but most of season 3 I missed. And I think season 4 will be coming out in the next couple of weeks, because the fifth and final season is going to be airing in September, so they should be releasing the fourth season on DVD pretty soon. And this is a series I really like, and just could not watch the third season due to just time, really, and just not being able to watch it. And I'm going to be watching this. Hopefully, by the time I finish watching this third season, the fourth season will be out. I'll be able to watch all of it. I missed the entire fourth season as well. And I'll be watching that, and hopefully I'll be caught up when season 5 comes out. Now, I did hit up my A1 Comics and found a couple of neat items. and a whole bunch of books. Catch up on some books. But first up, I got this here. This is The Walking Dead. I guess it's the Comic-Con exclusive. I'm not sure if it's exclusive or not, but this is based off the comic series of Walking Dead, obviously, based on the look of the characters there. And surprised to see it. I wasn't really expecting any Comic-Con related items to hit in my vicinity, but A1 Comics over in Roseville had this for $9.95, so definitely picked that up. And very interesting there. And also picked this up here. Now, this is a set that's been out for a while. This one here is the Star Trek two-pack of James T. Kirk and Spock in their pilot episode outfits, which is pretty cool. And this one here was a limited release. You can see here, Dilithium Collection here. It's numbered 865 of 1701. Nice number to produce of Star Trek figures there. But pretty cool. Thing is that it's missing one of his phasers, a Spock's phaser specifically. It doesn't look like it was removed because this packing here is glued into the card and there's no breaks anywhere I can see. Looks like they just forgot to pack it in. Now, this figure set was on sale for only $9.99, which is pretty cool. Now, I don't think it was on sale because of the missing phaser, because they had a whole bunch of Star Trek figures on sale, not just this one here. But for $9.99 for this nice numbered set that I probably will not open because it's a limited set. And with this missing phaser, I like to believe that mine is more unique than other 1700 sets. The other 1700 sets that are out there of this particular two-pack there. But $10 for this, I think it was a pretty cool deal. Now, I've been away from comic book reading for a while. Just dropped my reading schedule a little bit by I think about 3 or 4 months, but I did hit up when I was at A1 Comics really just a catch-up on reading. This is not A1 Comics, I'm sorry, this is Empire's Comics. I like to go to Empire's Comics for comic books because they have a nice selection, especially on the older issues, still at cover price. And really 3 or 4 months worth of books that I decided to catch up on. And got a whole bunch here. Let me just go ahead and pull these out and we'll go through them here. A nice big stack of books right there. And looks like the folks at Empire's Comics threw in this comic here for free. This is Justice League Dark number 4, and I already read this issue as soon as I got home, and I wasn't aware of this title, but I really like this title. I'm glad they threw this in there because I wouldn't have not known about this particular title. But I really enjoyed reading this. This is Justice League Dark. It's basically the DC occult team, I guess you could say. But this is definitely closer to a Vertigo type title than a standard DC title. And I guess it's set in the New 52, but I really enjoyed reading this. I really am going to start looking for the older issues and probably start following it. I really enjoyed reading it. It has a whole bunch of members, magic-related or occult-related, like Zatanna, and Constantine is in here, and just really Deadman, and Enchantress, I believe. And it's just a really surprising read. I really enjoyed reading this series. It's not for the younger folks. At least I don't think it is. It's more of an adult title, but I really enjoyed reading it. I am going to follow this from now on. Some other books I was able to pick up. He-Man and Masters of the Universe, number one. Pretty interesting. And I did pick up this here, Battle Beasts. Now, from what I understand, the folks that acquired the license for Battle Beasts are not using the, I guess, the original characters. These are all new characters set in a new storyline. So the connection between the old Battle Beast figures and there are some new figures coming out, and this title are really only the title itself. That's the only connection. I think whoever got the license or really got it just for the title recognition, but it's just all new characters on here, so very interesting. I decided to give it a try, and I haven't read it yet, but looks pretty interesting. I got number one, and I got number two here, and some comic shop news there, and catching up on titles such as Winter Soldier. I was able to pick up number 5 here, number 6, number 7, and number 8. Now I'm wondering, I'm curious if this title was because of the 2-pack figure that was released by Hasbro, or if the other way around. I'm not sure, but it's kind of interesting how these two are paired together, and they happen to have a 2-pack of figures of that, of them too. So I was also decided to give Avengers Assemble a try. There's so many Avengers titles, and I haven't been following Avengers in the book, so I think I tried briefly. I think it was Secret Avengers, or I can't remember, one of the other Avengers, but I decided to retry it again, but decided to go ahead and pick up Avengers Assemble. I think this is based off the movie characters in comic form. As you can see, all of the characters in this team are from, have made appearances in the movie on there. And I picked up number one, number two on there, number 3, and number 4, and number 5. I'm wondering how Bucky's gonna feel about this particular cover. And number 6, and it looks like with number 6 they're starting with a new storyline there, so that's kinda interesting, with the Guardians of the Galaxy. So pretty cool. I'll give that a try, see how that turns out. Other books, Walking Dead 100. This came out several weeks ago, and I remember seeing it, but I didn't pick it up. But picked it up this time, and I had heard, I got spoiled by a post on Facebook. It was cryptic. It was a cryptic post, but just based on the wording of the post, you knew it was a spoiler, and so I kind of know what happened in this particular issue, and I am just hoping, I'm hoping that the TV series does not follow this particular issue in the future. They seem to have gone their own separate way storytelling wise with the characters. It's different fate than the comic books, and I'm hoping that they stay that way with this particular issue. Really disturbing issue, actually. I was kind of spoiled, but going through the storyline, even though I knew the fate of this particular story here, it was still shocking. So, but very interesting issue 100 there. So, and decided to catch up on Justice League. Got number 9. Number 10, number 11, and also catching up on Invincible Iron Man, number 516, 517, 518, what looks like a new suit there, very interesting, almost War Machine slash Tron type imagery there. Number 519. 520. And 521. And 522. As you see, I have a lot of catching up to do with Iron Man there. Quite a few issues. Also have Suicide Squad number 9. And number 10. Number 11 here. A lot of focus on Harlequin, I noticed, on these issues. Number 12 on there. And also catching up, of course, on my favorite DC character, Nightwing. Number 9. Number 10. Number 11. I should say Dick Grayson more than Nightwing. And number 12. So quite a bit of catching up to do reading-wise. And should take up quite a bit of my time. And that's it for my casual peek into my Goody Haul for the third week of August 2012. My Goody Hauls will probably lessen with the good news of the house. So don't expect to see at least not as many or not as I guess plentiful goodies to show off, but I still plan to get some, but I don't foresee getting too many too soon, especially focusing on cleaning up the house and making it nice and pretty. And also, I just want to remember Nine Fires or Mike McBride again. Just a good friend, and he's going to be missed a lot, and I'll never forget him. Just one of the really good guys on the interwebs, and just a great friend to have had. And Nine Fires, or Mike, I'm going to miss you a lot. Hang loose forevermore there, and I'll never forget you, bud. This is my casual peek. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.